it looks, I mean, everyone on Faceless aside from CM has some sort of built-in escape. They've got, you know, either timber chaining away or blinking or rolling or whatnot. I don't know how the fights are going to look, and I'm super excited. I think if Faceless play this right, it could be pretty easy for them. But of course, Clutch, if they get strong lanes, they have the power to scale up incredibly quickly. Axe is really hard to walk against if you've got no levels. So this is a...
And like, how many times have you guys picked Wraith King in your pubs? Because you like watch some Wraith King clip, or
times.
You just think about Wraith King and how badass he is. And you're like, yeah, I love that hero. He's so fun. It's just one button god. And then the other guy, every game, they pick Ganymede. Every pub game, you want to play Wraith King.
There.
Oh, so, gonna have to... Whoop. Watch that, right?
I'm a good caster.
Nice.
There we go.
Easy.
I don't like the load-in for spectator. You don't get that fancy like anime battle screen. You just kind of go to the corner of the map and your map appears very slowly.
Or all pick, because we kept getting it during elimination mode, which is awesome.
Yeah. I was like, this is so cool. Like the battle screen, you can see the showdowns. Who do you think looks the most badass in the battle mode thing? The need charcoal. The hell are they doing charcoal right now? that's a poop emoji right there. All right. So any predictions for this game? Anything you think we're going to see that's out of the norm, out of the usual?
I don't know. I guess we have 100% confirmed. It is, yeah, Fly Soul going to be playing Bawkwork, just to make sure, I suppose, but so I loved his Elder Titan plays and everything too on that four and that roaming, so looking forward to this one. But his pressure will definitely be something to watch, how much he helps RML mids. I mean, we've seen RML, one of the unknown players to start this tournament, at least for me, not someone who I've seen in a long time, and certainly impressed by what he's put up so far on his Ember Spirit and Shadow Fiend plays. So the question will be just how much help does he get once he, like at the very beginning for his soft, get his stacks up, and then when those rotations do start coming in, like the pressure from XY into that mid lane, gonna be difficult, I think, for CG to balance just how much they need to help mid with this clockwork.
Dude, Shadowfeet looks pretty gnarly in cinematic mode. He's got all his, like, shit oozing everywhere. All right, so looks like we're gonna have a pretty typical setup. Here's the cogs thing that we talk about. So if you don't really get what's going on, he's got his necromancy first, so he picks up souls, and apparently cogs are living things. So if you deny cogs in the fountain, you get some souls to start out with. So a little bit more power, bringing it to the lane. Cost clockwork a little mana, but he'll sacrifice it.
I love how much better teams have gotten at it.
Oh,
they used to be so bad.
I used to watch them like struggle down the mid lane, and I think that was before you figured out you do it in the fountain, so they would like do it in mid, and then Clockwork would just start with no mana, and that's before Shrine, so he would just have a really tough time.
Yeah, and then they figured out this whole strat, where like you do it in the fountain for a bit, then you walk out, you buy one clarity every time on Clockwork, and then you just keep doing it every time cogs off cooldown as you walk towards the rune. It's pretty great. There's certainly a meta that's evolved.
Fly Solo, he's walking up the hill, and there we go, he goes in with the cogs. There's gonna be that Warlock heal put on him, like... right away, no chances taken, and they're gonna herd all of Faceless back to their side of the map. Really quick reaction there. If my nuts had, or rather, yeah, just nuts, had gotten the frostbite, it would have been a very different initiation.
Where'd we wind up? 9 stacks? You get half as max, it's not too bad.
Alright, we're gonna see if Hannah can fix the issue. Maybe some more charcoal is gonna help. I'm not a PC expert, though.
I often just shove charcoal right into mine.
Dude, you
just
put
open up the back,
in the disk drive,
shovel it
like,
in.
Squish it down so it's like USB size, just pack it in there. It's full of RAM, dude.
Yeah, it makes it go faster. Well, yeah, that's another good idea. They should just download more RAM.
I think that's what we're doing right now, just getting that RAM downloaded.
Well, till then. I mean,
I just like
looking forward to a black
in cinematic. It is art.
Oh yeah, he's got the like Diablo shoulders. I don't know. There's that whole set that makes him look so much like Diablo. It's awesome.
He is Diablo, dude.
It makes me just want to like play Shadow Fiend.
I thought you were gonna say play Diablo, because I could get down on that. All right, so I'm really impressed that Fly Solo was able to just to walk up to the top of that cliff where there was four heroes waiting for him and feel completely unfazed. Just immediate cogs, the warlock went in with the heal, and now Fly Solo is just walking at four heroes. I mean, why aren't Faceless engaging right here? They've got that level one frostbite from the Crystal Maiden, which is so strong. They can follow that up with the little bit of damage they got from the Ember. Are they just scared of ultimate retaliation by Clutch or what? Because Fly Solo just seems easy.
They don't know where the rest of them are. I mean, your AM has mana break. It's not really worth getting into anything. If there's an axe here and he just calls to your heroes, things could get a little bit nasty. So probably just not worth it for them in the end.
We gotta go. We gotta look at everyone's cinematic. Everyone's favorite. Very nice. Aw, dude, we got Anime Mage. I love this hair. I don't own it, but I want to.
Oh, that is pretty nice. I could see a spirit bomb powering up that guy.
Oh, yeah. Alright, so everyone else just going back to their respective sides of the map. No one getting too sneaky here as the horn is going to sound. The battle this would just begins. Be Black grabbing up this little top rune here. And everyone gets off to the start they were looking for.
Never refuse gold given.
Oh, I was wondering where that last one was, but it's just Jabs. Not quite there yet, so.
Oh, he's working on it. He had to walk himself all the way up here.
All right, well, Fly is shrining and going top straight up, so no help mid for our SF, of course. You know, yeah, the whole idea of the clockwork being that you don't really need that help, I suppose, so. See just how much pressure XY in turn will be able to put here. He's got his Orb of Venom. Himself some tangos, and he's going top. All right, later. Bottle on a ward, too.
All right, Armel already taken a sizable slash in the mid lane, but nothing they can't deal with. We'll see if Nuts is going to be going around here. I swear I'm going to call this Crystal Maiden my Nuts all game. Just used to saying it. Anyway, there we go. Black going in onto Hana. XY joins the struggle. First blood isn't going to be in this lane, but let's keep watching it anyway. Axe is one hit from death. They've got Nuts there who goes in with another frostbite. Will find the kill. Fly Solo going to get blocked in as well. They don't have any more lockdown as Crystal Maiden's fresh out of mana, so they can't get a double there. But kill score now 1-1, as we did see there was a death here in this bottom. Was it? Yeah,
it was
Timber.
Ice 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 got walked down.
Yeah, this is Ice 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 standing in, by the way. On our little...
Or plank, yeah.
Yeah, he's tagged as the stand-in, though.
Yeah.
He's very much part of the team, but just... That's who that is, if you were wondering.
Hey, he's gotta fix that, man. Whatever. He never has the right name, like, ever. It's like tradition at this point, honestly, so... I guess we'll allow it, but early on, Timbersaw, to be expected, only level 2 now. Hey, it's really not until you have at least the second point reactivator that you start feeling like a good hero. And at least his lane's in
God
a good spot.
God darn it. I'm missing everything wrecked here.
The double raise. RML. That is nice. Look at his HP too. That was just looks like Ember was salving and got caught out.
Ah. So Armel already having a pretty decent time in this lane. He was chunked down pretty early. I think he had to sit back, relax, eat up all his regen, because he is now a regenless Shadow Fiend. Has to play this one very safe. If Ember just kind of jumps at him and gets the better of the engage, it's all over.
Well, for now, I'm sure he'll be quite happy. Life's easy. You're level 4, you got 19 stacks. Look at Jabs. It's just like, oh, creeps, please. Come to the tower, let me farm you. Even Fly Solo shows up, giving that mana burn. Oh, we thought about it, he canceled it. Oh,
I'm looking at top lane there, and Anti-Mage went in, blinked in front, went for the body block so Nuts could get close enough to get that frostbite. Very well played. And now Timber, bro, you gotta play safe, dude. He's just in a very unhappy sandwich right now.
Oh, this is not the life.
I mean, he wants to just keep whirling death and onto a Ving, but they've got another stun, and Ving doesn't have to save mana for shit. All right, it's getting close. Who is it? Is it gonna be? Got that whirling death in 2 seconds, but oh, yep, okay.
Another name.
All right, I'm sure he got some levels, right? Yeah, he's almost level 4. Not too shabby. That was pretty funny. Totally body blocked there. Couldn't even like cut his way out with the whirling death.
Yeah, I mean, you saw him dying way up near his own tower here in the lane earlier. You see him struggling and, you know, hugging his own space, and then just you look down, he's cruising past the enemy tier 1.
All right, well, support's gone. Boot box out of mana, so in goes Ice Ice Ice. He's got that arcane aura. Just gonna start spamming. And level 3 now for Nuts. And oh, he goes 1-1-1 actually, so have to jungle up a little bit. There's a satyr as well. And, who needs jungle? We'll just head mid instead. Double smokes. Fly solo smoking here. Supports here. And this might be a dead clock.
Yeah, looks like clock is going to run into it. This time, not going to be so lucky. He gets off his cogs, but he's just tracking the problem close to himself. And there he goes. It's another little kill.
That's what we call a tank in the gank right there. Nice save, Fly Solo. What a player.
Yeah, he eats it up so Shadow Fiend doesn't take it. Very, very efficient.
Gotta keep those souls. 24. Mad damage. Spoonbox is still just hiking his way back. You know, this is... Yeah, you die as ice, but did he ever get a lost space? He got, like, almost an entire level in terms of, like, round the XP.
Oh, yeah. When it's just Timber versus Wraith King, just... You can destroy him pretty quickly. Just keep whirling death in him, and there's nothing really Wraith King can do. He's got a stun's worth of mana, and that's about it. Now we go, the Warlock. Spam heal, just keeping that Timbersaw a little bit unhealthy, keeping him staying a little bit farther back, buying some more space for the Wraith King to get in there, get nasty. In terms of last hits, our big leader is going to be the Shadow Fiend, of course, because he got such a lovely start in lane, got a kill, he's got a lot of space, ain't no one taking up his territory.
I like this Steven box. He gets a stack off down here. He gets some raindrops for himself so he can keep spamming out that Shadow Word. And they're going to bring down Fly Solo. Now, they don't know XY is here, so if they dive too deep, there could be a turnaround.
XY is going to have to get his body in the fight pretty soon. He's going to roll forward onto Boombex. Timber Chain out from our Timber Saw, but there's still three very angry heroes after the Dire side. They go in for another stun. The Timber Saw pulls through, but XY will still end up eating it. That's a killing spree for the Warlock. Now, they get the Wraith King down. That's going to be, all in all, not a bad trade here. Can't lose ice for this. He goes in, he's eating mangoes. This kid's ready to party.
It looks like he'll be okay along with Boombox, so definitely worth for Faceless. I mean, kill the Wraith King, trade your Earth Spirit, totally fine with that. Gold's going to your Timber Saw.
Absolutely. This poor Wraith King is having a tough time. Once he gets his ulti, we'll see it a little bit better, but mana's still going to be a problem for him.
Mana is always going to be a very sad story for poor Bay.
Speaking of mana, let's go check out our anti-mage up in the top lane, having a pretty successful time. 38 last hits for himself. Oh, back down bottom. We don't get a break, do we? Timbersaw just eating it once again, this time surrounded by three. That's going to be a nice little chakra. Fly Solo could be in some trouble. That's going to be Timbersaw getting that with a kill. Does he try to go against the Wraith King here? There's no mana for a Whirling Death. There's one magic stick charge, but... No, he's just gonna go heal himself up. They bring in Nuts, so they got the reinitiation if they need it on the Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, I like that too. Nuts just holding, just in case they turn back with the Wraith King, and wow, fully regen now. We saw Dota trying up for the mana too.
Oh man, that's efficiency right there. That's Dota 2. Up in this top lane. Deep dive there. Black able to blink himself into the trees. Axe just sitting there, content cutting the wave. Battle Hunger not available, but Call being threatened out.
XY, maybe?
I think XY might take one for the team.
Wow.
Look at that!
That was
fancy
worth watching.
Worth missing a kill.
Yeah, that actually was. That was pretty sick. But bottom, yeah, it's Wraith King again. I mean, if they're going to just camp Nuts down here, what can you do? This is a level 7 Timber Saw. Wraith King's level 5. Radiance, I mean, if he had ulti, it's not really going to change anything. Typical ice Dota, that's what we're used to. RML in the mid does have a DD though.
Oh, we're gonna see that come to fruition. There's RML, he's ready just to dumpster on everyone. The brief stun ties a little bit of time, but not able to go finish off XY. He's just chilling there. He's having a fun time. One raise will take him out. But again, you're content to trade your Earth Spirit for a kill on the mid lane.
Did you see those pings?
I saw some very upset.
Everyone's mid! That's what that was.
That's where's your missing calls, idiots.
Push on their lanes. Hurry!
Well, they're gonna push out something here as Black makes his way into the top lane, but he's going against an Axe. That's a very aggressive, bold move there. He can kind of hop himself away, but he's super low health. And they're gonna keep trying to bully this Clockwork down, but he can cut his way through the trees. Oh, they get back on top of the Axe. The Axe has no more mana. Black is solo, but they bring in Jabs, who actually brings the damage. And it will be a killing spree for Nuts as he pops that little Crystal Nova to get the burst damage necessary. Down in the bottom lane, no break from the action. So we got ice just sitting back, eating oodles of damage, but he'll be okay. He's a Timbersaw. Dire's middle
tower is under attack. Yeah, looks like top is simmered down as well. Dire's structures are fortified. What about Boombox? He's level 5.5, so closing in on the golems. might be able to make a rotation at that point. Fly solo, the other important one, unfortunately, not even level 4 yet. One of the more difficult aspects of this support clock, you really need either a bunch of kills or like every boundary.
Are they going for zero. This? Can I do this? Nah, they can't. They just want to protect their stack. Get Wraith King all that juicy solo farm he deserves.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Not quite able to pull off either.
But... Haste Rune Shadow Fiend with a full bottle just charging down. Let's see if he can chug against this Timbersaw. He's going in,
this
man.
This is risky.
And I do have the Earth Spirit. Going to drop a boulder, and that's going to be enough for Armel to back off. So some attempts coming out. I think when you see a Haste Rune, you just got to go for it. Your brain's got to switch to that bloodthirsty mode.
That's going to even go too crazy, though, with XY being nearby. And finds himself on those bounties, and Fly Solo gets a little bit of breathing room here mid too. So very important to this guy, so he can actually start contributing. Try and be that pseudo blink dagger for Raffy on the axe.
Here basically. We go, jumping in. Everyone's kind of missing their stuns, and there's the rock. Boombeck's going in, manages to get the heal off on himself. Ah, Bing gonna be chasing down XY. Meanwhile, down here we're gonna be reinitiating
there.
Onto the Timbersaw, but he gets stuck. Fly Solo solo. Oh. Timbersaw able to take him out before he goes down. Wraith King gonna be gobbling up those magic wand charges, living through that Crystal Nova put out by Nuts, but that was still a nice little play there by Ice. At least getting something for himself if he's going down. He's taking someone with him. RML just trying to bail, but that's not going so well for him.
I really like how free Black feels to just rotate like that. Like, they just... Searing Chains is... You know, just before it starts, Black is already TPing, you know? They're just like, look, I can kill this SF, just TP mid-Black. He's like, okay, thanks for the gold. I'm out of here.
Hey, that's how this team works. They're all just... They'll try something creative just because they know it's going to work. They have faith in each other. Definitely a good dynamic going on here. Rune of regeneration. Either way, looking at little net worths here, Shadow Fiend going to be still on the top of the chart, but with those two deaths and the time out of lane, it's going to be pretty difficult for him to maintain that lead unless he just... Really puts his nose to the grindstone and gets back to farming.
Yeah, and now we're at dream time for Jabs here. Level 10, gets the talent, gets the veil, time to go. He's in the fighting mode. No bots for this guy early on. Just wants to actually find some engagements. And it's good timing too. Raffy, 800 gold away from the blink dagger. They're not ready to be aggressive yet on the Radiant side. Unless they're going to do it through Fly Solo, which is a possibility. Maybe one of the golems are back up. They want to make some sort of rotation. But other than that, kind of want to see maybe your Ember Spirit teaming up down bottom or something like that. XY getting lost space top here too.
Yep, down bottom Timbersaw once again, trying his luck. But at this point, when everyone's got some levels, Timber versus Wraith King is not going to be a riveting battle of the death. It's just going to be two big guys slugging away at each other. But this kind of gank can definitely change things up. Three heroes moving down, smoked up. They got the rotation. More Radiant heroes coming forward, but Timbersaw, he's just doing God's work here. He's setting it up. There's the boulder coming in. Looks like Timbersaw is still getting low, but they got the magnetized rock, and they take out Wraith King's first light. The Fatal Bonds may still be enough to take out the Timbersaw. He's going to cancel his TP. He wants to go back in for this. He's in kamikaze mode, man. He's getting in there at whatever cost. Fly Solo will be going down inside his own cogs. There's a TP out of the Wraith King. After his reincarnation was burned, he just wanted to bail. So, overall, successful gank from Faceless, and Timbersaw lived the entire time.
Damn. That's intense. It's great timing by Faceless, too. Likely still knowing that the golems are down and not quite back up. Good time to make that pressure down into the Radiant safe lane. That's what we always expect from the Dire. It usually starts around 9 minutes, depending on certain cores, or a little bit later. You have an AM in the safe lane, so he's not making that rotation, and that delays it a little bit in this case to like 12. But they'll try and knock down this tower. They take over this part of the map. We get some wards going and try and limit where RML will be able to farm. He does have his Shadow Blade now, though, so that's going to sync up pretty nicely with Rappy, who's about to pick up his Blink Dagger. And with that Golems, there's a chance they could honestly just like 5-man wipe Faceless if they find the right fight now. Very big spike coming up for them.
Yeah, it's getting heated here. Again, looking at overall net worth, it is still a really close game. I think it's going to come down to how much work can the Shadow Fiend do. Is he going to sit back and farm for the next couple of minutes, or is he going to get really active with his team? And I think, like you mentioned, it's going to come down to where the next Warlock ult happens. Also, just a brief apology for my shit camera work. I'm on a new setup, and it's 3 in the morning, so you kind of get what you get. It'll get better, I promise. I'm working at the kinks. There we go. We are back into it. There is sufficient charcoal in the computers, and we are ready to go.
All right, excellent. Shovel that on in. Tower.
I'll never if someone could understand what they mean by are they like grilling? Do they got a heater that's like powered by charcoal? I just don't get it.
It's one of those like if you're feeling sick things, you can like put a little bit of charcoal and stuff.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, like the Edie kind of charcoal. Okay.
But I prefer the other thoughts.
Yeah, I didn't know if they were like dire. Doing really detailed charcoal sketches of the draft and the game plan or something, but
oh, there's another way to go. Yeah maybe that's what it is. Yeah, they ran out. Makes sense. Yeah, run down to the shop, the old artsy store. Rappy Tower, Blink Dagger, let's go! Look how rich he is with that tower.
Alright, Timbersaw's in, he's ready to go. Timbersaw, that's an ambitious play right there, sir. He's gonna go take Jabs away by a blast. I mean, Jabs is here. If Jabs can get a triple here, that's worth, but I don't think that's going the way that Jabs
oh, Ray fired one!
To.
Get him!
Got him!
Oh, no!
Got him! Oh, did you see that, dude? That kid's fucking dead.
Oh, that was so worth the golem. That was like 100% worth. That's actually so good.
Oh.
Dang. That was pretty awesome.
That is just right there. That's a check plus. Check plus. Well, either way, that is looking real good for Clutch Gamers. They go in and they take out two of the highest value heroes on the side of Faceless with Timbersaw. Coming back in, maybe Radiant are going to have to back off a little bit. They got the roll in coming from XY. They managed to get that little stun going, but the Warlock heal is still on this Wraith King. That is still a very ambitious kill. Crystal Maiden going to let it go, and they will find what they need. Wraith King's down, but two more heroes hit the deck, and it looks like Crystal Maiden's going to fall as well. Black, one of the lone survivors, trying to get himself back, but he's going to get stunned. The call is not going to connect as there is the blink away from Black. Very well played by the anti-mage, but unfortunately, with the rest of his team still dead, this tier 1 is donezo.
Wow. Nicely done. Good retaliation. Killing Ice just twice in a row like that is very painful for him. It's kind of funny with how much he's been like kind of owning this game. It's weird to look and see that he's 6-5-1, but yeah, I mean with the lane he's given, it's not that shocking. It's just,
we're talking about Ice here, dude. This guy is just when he's in, he's in, he's with it. If it's a bad choice, doesn't matter. Just follow through, and you gotta respect that kind of mentality. But yeah, he's been making a lot of space for his team. I think the entire time we've been focusing on Timbersaw going in under the tier 1, Black has just been like this, jungling up. He's got his full treads, got a full Helm of the Dominator before going on to finish up his Battle Fury. And here we go, top lane. Bing, I don't think it's looking so great for you, buddy. He goes in, there's no reincarnation available, and they give the kill to Black. So definitely high efficiency play. He's getting the money he needs for the next component of his Battle Fury. And that means he's only about 1,000 gold off from the whole thing.
Yeah, that's definitely what we call the ideal scenario. Yeah, Black's just chilling, farming some camps. Oh, let me just blink for a kill. Okay, great. Back to farming some camps. This is the life he loves to lead. But here we go. This is that big rotation we want. Now, there's no golems, but plenty of other options here.
Crystal Maiden, I think, is going to eat this one. Just take it for the team. And everyone else walks away. I think that's kind of the best of both worlds for both teams, honestly. Clutch feel like they got a successful gank, and Faceless are like, eh, it was Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, it's really good for Faceless too, because they placed that ward right on top of a Sentry and Observer, so the Dire know it's there. That'll get immediately dewarded. And they don't get anything else out of that. Tower's already down. They've taken all the tier 1s, so they have to go a little bit deeper. But at the same time, they also didn't run into a full 5-man without golems being quite up yet. So likely still kind of happy with that if you're CG. And now they can, again, go for that big rotation. Might wait for Rappy on the Blade Mail. He's close.
All right, Radiant very much making this top jungle their home. Nice aggressive ward put down by the Clockwork, so just making sure no rotations are going to be coming in without Radiant knowing about them. Meanwhile, Jabs going to take this opportunity to start poking at that tier 1 mid. Looks like there will be some TP response. Clutch don't want to let this go without a fight. They're going to bring forward Ah Bing, and there was a rotation in from the Warlock, who does have his golems available. So maybe looking for the old sandwich play. Crystal Maiden could be another victim. Oh god, Crystal Maiden, you poor thing. Just respawned. And she's just accepted death. She's going. If you come back, I'll
kill you again. Alright, tanking. It's fine. Sure, that's A-okay.
I mean, there's only so many times Crystal Maiden can take one for the team before she's just crippled. Looks like she's...
Wait, look where Black is, though. Like, they're waiting for one person to rotate and then try and get a kill with XY. Do it, They're still like kind of baiting it here, but
Dire's middle tower.
It doesn't look like they're gonna come back, so Radiant's Black will just have to try and force a trade.
Radiant structures are looks like both teams are pretty okay with that. Tier 2 for tier 2 action going on. Mid lane taken out, and that, yeah, that Clockwork, he had the highest of ambitions, but nope, not even a little.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Oh, XY though.
They know he's trapped in the trees, he's got that rolling boulder cooldown. 5 more seconds, is he actually gonna make it out because Avin got distracted by creeps? My goodness.
Well, if you get to here and you don't see him, you're like, alright, he TP'd out already. There's no way he's still in here.
That guy is the Ring Around the Rosy Champion 2017. Radiant's top tower is falling.
Okay, well, they don't end up getting the tower, though, so still a favorable trade for CG. Mm-hmm. Now we start eyeing towards Roche being the most important thing in the map. Mine. And it's a fairly easy take for the Radiant. It's, you know, they've got, three levels up in Presence of the Dark Lord now, level 15. It can, as long as they have their cooldown and the Golem being the most important one, then it shouldn't be too bad. You definitely, I think, want to try and get it before there's a Manta up on Black, and you don't have a giant window.
Yeah, he is just, the last 2 minutes, he's been chugging away, finished up the Battle Fury, and of course that's making things very easy farming-wise. He's got his pet Centaur just traipsing around looking for danger ahead of him. Good micro. And then, yeah, working on that Manta, like you mentioned, he's already got pretty much enough gold for the Yasha. He's just saving up for bigger, badder things here. Back to our mid lane, we got our Ember Spirit who has his Blink on top of his Veil. Does he go back in for bots or does he start with the damage items?
You would think bots for sure. He's the most calm pick up here. Man, he has really been slowed down. I like how they've been scouting with our Mel here too. And well, he will reveal. He went straight for the Silver Edge just to help out with the Animage and the Timber Saw. Pretty smart. I mean, it's not the best against Timber, but obviously it's very good against AM if you have any magical damage. And it's going to help tank him up a little bit. And he'll eventually get his BKB anyway. Doesn't look like there'll be too many decisive fights before then. And fort down bot. I think they already forwarded on Dire though, and they did. So see if they make a rotation down to try and save this or just keep pushing. And looks like push is the option here. I mean, if you can open up the shrines.
Yeah, that very nice first high ground is so critical. And I mean, our Faceless really just going to give this away. They go, they trade, they get the tier 2 bottom. Finally, Timbersaw able to finish that. And I guess they're feeling like there's going to be some rotations, and they are right. Three heroes, TP back. And that's going to be a defended high ground. So overall, map is pretty even globally. No one's cracked high ground yet. Some tier 2s are starting to go down. The cores are getting their big items up. Anti-Mage is now first on the net worth chart. Overtakes the Shadow Fiend, so things are starting to get a little bit more interesting than they were a couple of minutes ago.
Yeah, and now we still, again, just lie in wait for Roche. It's exactly when CG feel comfortable heading in there or making a big smoke play to try and find a pick. And now with the ward, they spot jabs. They have a blink dagger on a Bing. Decent initiation. They can lead off with that. And he doesn't have a remnant down.
Yep, he is about to get dropped on. They go, they wait for his sleight of fist. Got the one remnant and scoots himself to freedom. Very well played.
The hook. Might not have been enough anyway, but perhaps it would have bought more time for Raffy to get there.
Either way, everyone getting away safely, just making some motions around the map. I mean, you can tell Clutch Gamers really want to go. They want to mount a really strong push onto the high ground. They've got Warlock Golems at the ready. The problem is just making sure you got eyes on all of Faceless to make sure they're not waiting in the trees to jump you.
They really need these bots on Jabs. Once that happens, Jabs can like swap with Ice. And like Jabs can be the one down here doing this kind of shenanigans.
Astonishingly close.
Yeah, and it's such a big deal to them. Because then you have this Timbersaw who can like actually be in the fights and starting things off and not even committing to stuff. Whereas your Ember kind of has to commit when he dives into a fight like that. Alright, we're just sending him in alone.
Yep, there's no way this can go wrong. Oh look, Roche is winning.
Dude, Roche is actually owning.
Roche is a strong boy.
Alright, you need a little help.
Yeah, there we go. Bringing in our Mel. Got a little damage rocket. We didn't talk about the full BKB now.
Oh my
now.
God, he just goes crits up.
Yeah, get it, boys. 4 points in Mortal Strike. Oh, the Centaur!
Never refuse gold.
Alright. Oh god! They killed it! Warlock Midas the Centaur.
Just got wrecked.
poor buddy.
And ex-wife.
There we go. They move forward. They want to go onto Axe. A little too late to snap the Aegis up. And Radiant, they're looking strong. They lose their Shadow Fiend. Or rather, they lose their Axe. The Shadow Fiend's able to channel up the Requiem. But all the Dire, they make it safely to the trees.
Oh, the flare. Oh, it went over.
Bing, he's going in for more here. He's got to be careful. This guy does not have the Aegis, and he's going to get focused down by the Anti-Mage. They do get the kill onto the Wraith King. Armel, oh! They pop the Aegis as soon as the Shrine is activated. He's still got this wad of heroes moving forward. Warlock doing his best, but at this point, he's just sitting still. They want to go for the Shadow Fiend. There's the big kill that they need, and Jabs continues to pressure forward. And he's got pretty much nothing else to go on here. He uses up his blink. They've got to get some sort of catch, and there's Black blinking in with the body blocks. It's a full team wipe in favor of Faceless. Very well done. Dire, they don't get the Roche, they don't get the Aegis, but they get all the kills they could possibly want.
That would be an example of, I mean, I don't know, support Clockwork, like, if you have your Force Staff and stuff as a Clockwork in those scenarios, you can make so many more plays around the Roche pit, but Clock just has like that one chance for his to initiate, try and win the fight with nothing but Tranquil Boots and an urn, and you're like walking with this battery assault, and they jump the Axe too, so the fact that Rappy's the first one to die just makes that fight so much more difficult. It was so spread out that they didn't have a good area to place down the golems and make it really effective, so you don't see it until this whole shrine scenario, and the fight's already over at that point anyway.
That's gotta be so heartbreaking. You make it up to the high ground, you see sweet freedom there in the shrine, and you die right as it starts. But again, he came back and had a few sweet moments of freedom before he was killed again.
Well, now, BKB 9 seconds for RML, and Aegis gone. I believe they got the gold and everything too, so, I mean, at least there's that, but definitely a good run back for Faceless. We have those desperate need items, and nope, man. Let's see if they left anything in the pit, perhaps, but
I thought they were looking for Roche. I'm like, you're a little soon. All right, there we go. Bing, maybe caught out here. The warding from the Radiant is mostly aggressive, and they've got nothing defensive, and unfortunately, it's going to mean that this is going to happen a whole lot. He does have his reincarnation, if he can save up the mana here, and he's just taking it like a champ. And there's the TP in from Hana to the Shrine. They want to go finish off this Crystal Maiden. Boombax is there just to rake it in, but there's the rest of the cores coming in. It was a great bait all along. And they've got this Wraith King down. They take out the Axe as well. Hell yeah, you'll trade a Crystal Maiden for that.
Yeah, CG have definitely lost their moment where they get to pick the fights. With the bots being up on Jabs just makes it so much easier. Black has that Manta. He absolutely destroys. His damage just increases immensely. And all RML can really do is either be there when the fight starts, or he's just split-bushing the whole time. Now they're wrapping. They have a gem on XY, too.
They're trying to go in, but I don't think he's too spooked by this. He goes in, he's BKB, and he's going to get off his Requiem and his Death Requiem, which will end up taking out Jabs, but he doesn't get experience for that kill. He was already dead. Meanwhile,
that was pretty sick that he actually even got one.
Focused down by Ice. This guy is getting real aggressive. We're behind tier 3s here. We're high ground. Shrine activated. Blink in from Ah-Bing. I think Timbersaw may have flown a little too close to the sun here. He's getting low, but does manage to make the chain all the way up onto the cliff. But there's the hook shot. Oh, beautiful play. Ice solo. Just keeping eyes on him, keeping on top of him. But do they actually have the distance to get this guy down? No, Timbersaw just kiting away. And a regen rune to boot.
20 bloodstone charges.
That's fair.
Regen rune. Okay. CM aura.
This guy is just made of mana. You puncture him and his mana flows out instead of blood. That is absurd. And looks like he's got the recipe for the boots of travel as well. He's going into the Shiva's guard, and this guy will not be killable in about 5 minutes.
It's actually proper positioning around the map that we've been seeing from Jabs and Black. They've like not even coming close to these guys. Like, their movement seems so predicted by Faceless. Especially when you have a Clockwork and a Wraith King just farming under wards.
Hey, how does Wraith King get off the struggle bus here? Because he's had himself an armlet and a blink and boots for a really long time, and he's making progress towards the BKB, but you look at the net worth and he's still riding below half in terms of and a little bit out of control. I mean, is Wraith King just trying to make this up by taking the game way long? Because it feels like that's not how you win against an anti-mage. He's content with that. He'll fight you late game all day long.
Yeah, he's just... don't know, he's a Wraith King at this point. Most of your damage comes from your Shadow Fiend. He's like basically just a core, a carry that can at least control. And oh, Rappy, nice Vanta dodge. Damn.
Oh yeah, we're getting here. Everyone TP into the shrines. Initiation from Fly Solo goes in, hops into the cogs, and Anti-Mage could be in some trouble, tries to blink away. The rock is dropped, but Black does make it down to the low ground eventually. There's a blink on the axe to try to chase him, but looks like everyone's going to go back to where they were now, and that's pretty major for Clutch Gamers. They invested a Warlock Golem for that and got nothing in return. Meanwhile, down bottom, there's some push onto the tier 3s, a couple strikes onto the Ember Spirit, but he's going fine. And that means no Golems left to defend this if Faceless really do want to make a push.
Yeah, they're just not on any sort of a timer either. As you said, not exactly fun to head to much later.
I mean, sure, there's the 60-minute scenarios where things start to even out a little bit more here between our lineups, but overall, you're pretty happy splitting the map, ratting, farming as much as you can on the side of Faceless, getting that next tier of items, Black eyeing a heart for himself.
There we go, TP's in, Hana just trying his best. Gets off a really nice call with the blade mail, but has to BKB just to walk around, and that's a big BKB charge to use. That was his first one, full 10-seconder.
Seems like he lives.
Right now, Faceless are super good at baiting out really high-value things from Clutch Gamers. First the Golems, then the BKB, and they're not getting anything out of it right now. And
Robux recipe.
Yeah, he's not feeling good. And that's going to be another Tier 2 tower, and this is what Clutch Gaming were so scared of. They've now got no Golems to defend this, they've got no BKB on the axe, and Ice is just chewing you apart behind the racks. Armel, he's got the Requiem, he's got the BKB, he's going to be his team's big chance of having a successful fight here. And he's going to try that Requiem, but it's barely focusing down the Anti-Mage. There we go, they got the lock. Very nice stun. Will get a 6-streak onto Armel. There's the money he needs. Is this working out? Jabs going to town onto the axe. Meanwhile, there is going to be Timbersaw finally taken out. That's Armel. I mean, he's looking good. They go in with another Wraithfire Blast to reinitiate here, and the Ember Spirit's dead as well. It's a 2-for-3 so far, but definitely favoring Clutch Gamers. Armel somehow brought the damage to that fight. I thought it was too ambitious, but he done it.
That was pretty funny. That was definitely just a little bit too crazy. Not much else to say about that.
Fight of the supports. And there's nothing you can do against TP unless you're willing to drop Golems. And even if you had the Golems, that's not quite a worthy investment.
Well, that was something.
Ice is already back down bottom, though.
This guy is full go, go, go. Nuts trying to do what he can to defend this mid, but Armel, he's just starting to go with the right clicky clicky. XY goes forward, blinks out of danger just in time. Now this guy's holding a gem as well. Crystal Maiden will be focused down. She goes into her Ghost Scepter form, but they've got plenty of magic damage to take her out. Earth Spirit has to be so careful not to lose this gem. It's so valuable with all the wards
go
that are going
racks.
Down.
Do it! Do it! They're doing it!
Yes, sir, they are. Timbersaw's coming back, though. They got this Wraith King. One of the racks has fallen. They get the Wraith King's first life. There's a TP in from the Anti-Mage. Now Black is ready to rumble. But smoke away. They're just going to clean up the remnants of their lane. And that is going to be half a lane of Super Creeps in favor of the Radiant. And the Shrines are vulnerable now as well on the Dire side of the map.
Well, mistakes were made. I know there was a lot of weird stuff that happened in that fight on the Radiant high ground. Jabs?
What? He is playing a dangerous game. Black as well, so close to an area that they know is dangerous. Are they actually going in for this? Roll forward, and they've got the Golems to drop. This is Black potentially in some serious trouble. He's going to get stunned by the Wraithfire Blast. He blinks himself away. They cannot afford to lose Anti-Mage there. Ice dives into all of them. This guy is not scared of anything. That's going to go with them to the Frostbite. They sure would love to get the Clockwork killed. They do, but it will cost them their Crystal Maiden. TP out from Armel. Can they break it? Yeah, they can. They got that kill and roll forward. Initiation onto the axe again, even through the blade mail. They easily cut him down. The only survivor is the Wraith King, just walking around his jungle, mourning his former teammates, because that was a murder.
Yeah, recovery mode.
Yeah. That's Faceless. Back. They say, all right, fucked up a little bit, attack. Non-efficiency, lost Arax, let's get right back in this and take Arax of our own.
Yeah, that's pretty much almost the exact same net worth swing and stuff, so at least they do have buybacks right now on the Radiant side. We still have ulti from a Bing. might consider buying back on our mill. They're definitely going to lose a tier 3 though, so shrines will go down.
Radiant's top tower.
There's no way Black doesn't stay for this.
There we go. Radiant's got him. Tower has fallen. And yep, safe retreat as Ice is going to be drawing some attention into the top lane, but able to blink himself out. So shrines vulnerable on both sides of the map. We are soon going to see a shrineless Dota 2 map. And that means the Roche control is going to be a little bit tricky for both sides. But speaking of Roche, Faceless hop themselves right in the pit. Clockwork does scout that out with the rocket flare. So Radiant know exactly what's up, and I don't think Dire can take this quick enough, so they bail out of the pit.
Ah, nice flare by Fly Solo, just to confirm their suspicions. And there is a ward from the Dire on the shrine, so they would have spotted the SF rotation. They might try and camp something here, try and make some sort of a play. Radiant Vision, they see up here. They don't see XY quite where he is, but now they will. Dire should know they're here, judging by that flare. Butterfly now done here. That's actually pretty huge. MKB for a while on Black.
An AM? Is he flapping it into himself?
Oh no, like just the butterfly onto our ML.
Ah.
Yeah, just knocking over MKB for a while. The opponents.
They were talking about anti-mage and I'm like, I think that's an abyssal. He does have an abyssal. Interesting talking point. That's going to be fun in these team fights because it feels like Faceless, they've already got a decent amount of lockdown there, zip-zapping in and out of these fights, and now Anti-Mage can just completely focus someone down. Speaking of focusing down, Roche hits the deck once again, and that's going to be an Aegis on our Anti-Mage.
I love DDs at Roche timings, hey?
Yes, this seems...
great stuff, honestly.
Anti-Mage just slapping at you for like 300 a pop. Now, Radiant, they don't seem too happy with this. They're going to go forward. Black uses the Manta.
Dude, these Manta dodges are actually insane.
Oh, my goodness. Now, it looks like our Timbersaw could be in a little bit of trouble, but again, he's still got 18 Bloodstone charges. They bring Black back in. Easy kill onto Boomfax and Ah Bang just circling around. They burn down his mana before the Reincarnate hits, so he's just super dead. Now they're going in. They'd like Clockwork as well. He's going to go shoot himself up to the high ground, but... it's only buying a little bit of time. Call from the axe, but heals off, just takes care of that real quick. Hana just having to fight underneath his own tier 4s as the rest of his team goes to work on the top racks. Black just getting a chance to focus everything he wants down. Ice is going to poke onto the mid lane. Now, this is ambitious here. Link forward from the axe. They have the Shadow Fiend. That's the damage they need to turn this fight. Fly Solo gets low, but able to walk himself back to Shrine. Black still hot on his heels under the Shrine. Still wants to fight, but Black may have to go ahead and blink right on out of here. He does not want to lose the Aegis for nothing.
Well, they lose their melee racks, so we're even Stevens in terms of the racks count. And where are we in net worth? I feel like, Faceless have a huge advantage. 15k at this point. That makes sense. I mean, with an AM and a Timber and an Ember, just like three heroes are so good at farming across the map. I tell you, Earth Spirit is just such a hero. He lets you do whatever the hell you want with your other three cores. This guy's so ridiculous. He is an initiator. He can, like, do all that shit. You don't need initiators when you have this guy. And then you just get these insane high damage heroes like Timbersaw. And, you know, a semblance of control out of your Ember Spear, but he's not a full
right,
XY. He's a damage guy.
Solid roll, buddy. Made it all the way up there. Anyway, we do have Earth Spirit working on the Ag, so our Earth Spirit's about to get even spicier.
What a hero.
Yeah. And speaking of heroes, Black, top of the net worth, is just still going at it. I mean, what does the Anti-Mage have left to buy? He's still chilling with the helm in his backpack. He's got Abyssal. He's got all his nonsense once Aegis runs out. I mean, does he go MKB, or do you just kind of not care?
Well, he went for a butterfly of his own.
Yeah.
He'd been eyeing that heart for so long, I wasn't sure if he was actually going to do it, but that changed his mind. Probably the right call here. Definitely do not. Once the Chrysalis is up on the... Shadow Fiend too, it just makes it so much better. He might go back for a Bloodthorn though if he sees this butterfly. He might as well at this point. Like if you see this evasion on Black, need something to deal with it, and already having the Chrysalis, it'll probably make more sense to have Bloodthorn.
Yeah, it's all about just the chaos of the fights and making sure you actually get it off on the right target either way. Shrine taken down on the bottom side of the map. That means Radiant ain't got more shrines. They're done, man.
Now they can just sit on their base. We still have the issues of, you know, Axe, decent high ground defender. The chains from Warlock can always just win you a fight, even at this point. We have double golem action. But the rat is real from the side of Faceless. I mean, they don't want to make the same mistake they made the first time they came high ground. They needlessly went too deep, didn't pressure all three lanes at once like they could have. And they got majorly caught out. Now, it could have been because they were trying to force this 5v5 fight because they don't want someone getting picked off by Clock and Axe on like a second lane, which makes sense, and I can understand that, but they just gotta make sure they don't dive too crazy deep this time like they did prior.
I have the hiccups.
Hiccups? Oh my goodness.
It's not great.
Man, I hate the hiccups, honestly.
Is Ember Spirit supposed to look dirty? Is that just
Ember, Earth or Ember?
Ember. He just looks like he's in a cloud of dirt.
The Eternal Envy set, man. He's in the desert.
Yeah, I've seen the set before. It just usually looks more like goldeny instead of just dirt. All right. I guess I'm in the wrong.
Desert beauty.
Ah, oh, it's beautiful.
I like this set.
I like the set.
It makes me want to play a hero that I don't play.
We got initiation. RML chunked to half, but not going to be able to find his fancy requiems here. Meanwhile,
I got ice.
He's tanking it for the team. We're gonna actually see any help. He's just making it to the trees and then he dies.
Oh, no deny.
But making space. Look at that. Rax whittled down to half health. Anti-mage goes in and can actually take a fight here. Warlock's still holding onto the golem. Shadow Fiend's still holding onto the Requiem. There's so much damage in the Radiant. The Dire just have to back out and keep farming up and try again.
I like that the Radiant invested in the gem too. Despite being down quite a bit, it can be very difficult to get into that as a support. But making sure there's nothing on this high ground. Might even find this ward in a second here. He ventures outside the base. And he's almost into the Aghanims. He's not that far away. I think you hold buyback, though, if you're this clockwork. I don't think you're one of those position fours that can afford to throw it away.
Boom, there it
goes. Oh, actually, if you have Aghanim Scepter, that's actually totally worth it. I'll take it back. Oh, I'm gonna do a public service announcement. Did you have your camera on Fly Solo right there where he just killed that ward?
I did.
Okay, if you guys are playing your pubs, please remember if you're a melee support, you can do that. You can hit high grounds now.
Yep.
Too many times I'm playing on the other side of the map, yeah, and someone's like, oh, I need range support, please come. I'm like, dude, can you just like click it?
Can you just try?
You click it.
Just like try a little bit.
Just please. Also, have you ever used that whole courier deliver items menu thing?
Like where you can send it to the person before you?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, dude, easy mode.
I'm so guilty of not getting used to that one yet. That's my confession. I still like immediately start typing Recro.
I do too, but mostly because I'm just real lazy.
Fair enough.
Yeah, sometimes if I actively steal the courier from someone that was definitely using it, I'll send it back to them. But if someone
was way too much cool shit in that patch for me to see that and fully commit to it, you know? Like, that should have been,
absolutely,
like, a slightly after patch. I mean, there were talents. I didn't have time to look at courier
Dude,
menus.
Talents, shrines, what the hell is a backpack? My inventory is bigger. The HUD looks different. Hold me, I'm scared. Like, there were so many changes. But that is one that gets undervalued there. If you right-click this bad daddy, you can send it back to the person that had it before you if you took it. PSA, in case you didn't know the old Dota tip.
Is good. This is one of these games where we need these things. You know, this is right now, I mean, this is what the Radiant have to do, and this is what the Dire have to do, so all their movements are understood. You know what's happening. One more minute till Roche. Faceless choosing not to make the same mistake again here.
Oh, I got it. There's the vision. Clockwork's D ward means nothing now, huh?
Oh, I've been looking at that old HUD a couple times now, and I gotta say,
it looks
blocky. What were we? It looks awful. I know. Some people are like, get mad when you say that, but you look back and you're like, holy shit. Like, skills were so huge. Like, what is wrong with us? We look like a bunch of old people that we need our skills to be so big. They're like four times the size, it feels like, compared to these ones. And now I look and I'm like, all right, this is like totally fine. Like, I don't need skills that are that huge.
Yeah, there's the more important part. Like, we now got like some green open space between the minimap and the HUD, and then the HUD and the quick buy. Like, that used to just be filled in. Like, we just took up more of the screen for absolute nothingness.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
But, you know,
I definitely like feel nostalgic looking at it, but my god, I actually can't believe how big the skills were. They were huge. They're like the size of like the new face portraits, basically.
They were, it's just so much. And heroes with like 15 icons, like you get a Rubik with two shits to steal, that is, that's just your whole screen. But yeah, I was firmly in the faction that despised the new HUD, thought it was offensive that Valve would try to change it.
We've left the base, Annie. We're out.
I'm looking, there's nothing going on. We're smoked. We're still hunting. There we go. Roshan goes down. Cheese on the ground, picked up. Aegis goes the way of Black. And they're just going forward there. That's an abyssal onto Boobex, but he gets off the ult before he goes down. Is it going to be enough? Armel, he's BKB, and he drops the Requiem. Do they have the damage to kill the anti-mage? They're still hunting. Crystal Maiden goes. She drops her ult, but she's still running. I don't think she gets away from this. That's going to be a Culling Blade right to the face. Radiant, they're still chasing down. Ah, Bing running with the last life he's got. He picks up the gem and then immediately has to pop his reincarnation. Meanwhile, Axe, Yule stuff in the air. Let's see if this is going to be enough to just clean wipe the Dire. Ice gets so low, but he's got so much mobility now. Looks like everyone else will escape, so Anti-Mage still holds on to the Aegis throughout that entire fight, manages to blink to safety.
Wow, great stuff by Raffy to catch out that Ember.
Yeah.
Right off the bat, like, didn't even have a chance to pop the cheese. It's completely chain stunned down, and so important that you find that exact hero, right? You gotta get the guy who did not get the Aegis, their super important core, and just go for the win. So very well done. Fight is saved, game is saved for now. Yeah, as you said though, unfortunately, they were so close to getting Black on that high ground. Like, unbelievably close to him going down. He got Cogs pushed and he was so low, but he just blinked away in time to save that Aegis. Ice.
I mean, there is going to be XY there, but looks like everyone's just trying to bail out. Fly solo now looks like an appetizing kill. Already focused down to half health, but Armel is here. This is dangerous. The BKB is ready. Black pops into the Manta, but he's still stunned up. Nuts doing what he can, but oh gosh, Black. He blinks himself away. He's barely alive right now. Looks like he wants to go back into the fight. Does have the Aegis, remember, and they will find the kill that they need. Bane gets down low as well. He's going to go ahead, get reincarnated once again. The rest of the Dire, they're so low, but they're still together. Crystal Maiden's ulting. Looks like Anti-Mage's Aegis will be popped, but gems are on the deck, and Abing, yeah, he's super dead.
So, they cut the trees, so Timber couldn't get that. It was kind of funny, but...
Alright, yeah. Dire team going back to recharge, at least the ones that need to recharge, but Black is content just to start working on the rack. Still has that Manta if he needs to bring a little more manpower in, but of course wants to save for the sick Manta dodges.
Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack. I'd be at least a little bit worried about this SF possibly showing up in Viz like that, but they do get the melees, and they head mid. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Alright, moving in. Ice goes, eats up some spells, but Black is...